هذا الاتجاه أن سبدرا من ولد البدر فقد نوجهه للبدر مش سبدرا مثلا مش كانت هي doing a PhD at the Dr. Pranishwari on Brihat Samhita. She was a very popular Sanskrit teacher in Mayapur, and many people of different backgrounds from Chennai came to her to learn Sanskrit, and she helped her students in all possible ways. She was also helpful in some of our publications. Unfortunately, few years before, when there was a seminar in Bangalore on mathematics, ancient Indian mathematics, she also presented a paper there. She was admitted into the hospital, but she passed away. So in her memory, all her students, family members, and her friends instituted this endowment to have a lecture in her memory every year in the month of June. And this year we have been thinking of having this lecture. Unfortunately, due to the blessings of Professor M.S. Rangachari, we were introduced to one of the greatest mathematicians that our country has produced, Professor Sridhar. He is happily with us today. He is a great professor in Chennai Mathematical Institute. More about him later. And our institute has been doing a lot of work in the field of not only Sanskrit literature, because people think Sanskrit means only literature or religion or philosophy. But we found that little work has been done in the scientific area. So of late, we have been concentrating more on diverse fields of science. And Dr. Sita Subramanian, presently the secretary of our institute, presented a thesis which was later published as a book on Indian algebra. And then Dr. Rama Balani also presented a thesis on a text called Pruthi Vilasini, which is a commentary on Bhaskara's text. And another student has produced a thesis on Sridhara and Sripati, and another candidate produced a thesis on SIRS in ancient mathematics. Like that, of late, within these 10 years, our institute has made rapid stride in the field of mathematics. In the same way, we thought of indulging ourselves in different aspects of ancient Indian law, women's law, dream psychology, lexicography, and oceanography. And one of the theses on submarine fire, which has been acclaimed by the expert examiners as one of the best, has come out because of the efforts of one professor here, Professor Bhartasarathi, former professor of geography, who is holding a chair in the name of Sri B. Madhav, Department Secretary of our Institute. Presently, he is in the US. And we want to do geology, geography, the evolution of earth, as has been described in our ancient Puranas, which are so close to the modern theories, and the geographical ideas that are contained in ancient Puranas. And also we are doing a lot of work in the field of medicine, for example genetics, pathology, surgical instruments in ancient India, so on and so forth. We want to do some work in chemical, chemistry, physics, and then art and architecture. One candidate has produced a text on ancient Indian architecture, temple architecture, which has also been published. So the field is expanding. And I am conscious of not talking about yoga. We have produced a lot of presentations on yoga. Now that only yesterday we have celebrated International Yoga Festival. And I am proud to say that ASRA has produced more dissertations on yoga than any other university. So, with this background, we are thinking of producing at least 100 monographs in the field of mathematics, physics, chemistry, oceanography, medicine, and many other metallurgy, many other branches of Indian science, art, architecture, economics, quality, so on and so forth, starting from the Vedas. And as a first trial, we want to do some real work in the field of mathematics. So we were approaching different people to help us, and fortunately for us, we had one very generous person holding a very high position in Canada Bank. This was Srimati, who is deeply interested in not only Sanskrit but Indian culture, anything connected to ancient Indian systems of knowledge. She readily agreed to sponsor the first publication on ancient Indian mathematics. Because if we say Sanskrit, because we have been visited by some general managers of the Methodist Bank, they always say that Sanskrit means it is a Brahmin's language and we are a secular country, we may be facing a lot of questions on such things. So we wanted to put it as ancient Indian mathematics, and Dr. Srimati immediately said she would grant the cost of the first publication, and we have envisaged a series of 10 such publications in different branches of mathematics. The first will be an introduction to ancient Indian mathematics, what contribution India has done in the field of mathematics. Then we will also produce books on the concept of zero, and then infinity, surds, geometry, trigonometry, so on and so forth. So, in this way, we want to produce at least 10 books. And we would request any of you here, with your good officers, to sponsor one publication in any such venture of our institute to help us in the publication of such things, so that ancient knowledge contained in our scriptures are known to the world. And I heartily welcome Dr. Seeral, who meets us today. He is going to talk about a wonderful subject connecting mathematics with Chandas and also music. This is also not strange to us, sir. One of our dissertations, one candidate has done on an ancient text on Chandas called Manibhushanam, which he has talked about the Pascal theory as well as the Mantra Chandas, but also some of the mathematical systems that are contained in ancient Chandas Shastra. It is said that Chandas Shastra even Pindala comes home, the concept of nothing. So in this way, a lot of things are contained in our ancient literature. And Dr. Sridharan is a very competent person to talk on this subject. We heartily welcome you, sir, and this is today, and thank you for accepting our request. And Mr. Srimati, we thank you very much for taking the time to come over here as a chief guest. We take this opportunity to thank Sri Sundara Delia of Canada Bank, who was so enthusiastic. He came and visited here, and the branch manager of Canada Bank, Mayapur, Mr. Balasubramanian, and the staff of Canada Bank, who have supported us in this venture. So a hearty welcome to all of you. And the D.S. Krishnamurthy, former Chief Financial Commissioner of India, does not require any introduction to any of you. He is the president of our institute. After he has taken over, we have been making much progress in so many fields of our research. He has been blessing us with his presence as well as all the assistance that he can do in his official capacity. We sincerely thank him for coming over here today for this lecture. Once again, I welcome you all. Thank you very much.
Our secretary will now introduce the speaker. And I have to...
Welcome, Sam. Today a very difficult task contained achievements of such a scholar as Dr. Sridharan. Dr. Sridharan was born on July 1939 at Kadalur in Tamil Nadu. He completed his master's degree in Vivekananda College, Chennai, and joined TAFR in 1955. Dr. Sridharan departed for Columbia University in 1958, where he completed his PhD in filtered algebras and representations of live algebra. Ancient algebra, but this is Greek and Latin to me. It was called the algebra. After returning to TAFR, Dr. Sridharan began mathematical life as a thesis advisor almost immediately, supervising the doctoral work of Amit Roy, Srikant Mahadev, Bhattwadekar, Bhongare Chabate and others. In 2000, Dr. Sridharan bid farewell to the Rom Association TAFR, but had no hesitation in moving to Chennai Mathematical Institute to continue with his teaching and research. He has also made many contributions to his other pet passion, history, especially the history of mathematics, and in particular, ancient Indian mathematics. Being a polyglot, his expertise in Sanskrit, Tamil, German, and contemporary literature has been widely reflected in his articles and lectures. Due to his competency in Sanskrit language, the production group of the only existing Sanskrit movie on the life of Adi Shankara, directed by G.V. Iyer, approached him to help them with English subtitles, which he successfully did. He has authored an English translation of Sri Ramanujacharya's commentary on the Bhagavad Gita and an English translation English translation of Thiruvalluvar's Kamathupad. He is also very versed in Ayurveda. His beautiful work on enumerative combinatorics in prosody, the works of Pingala, elliptic function, to mention just a few, demonstrate the breadth of his interest and the depth of his research. Some of his articles pertaining to ancient Indian mathematics are Mathematics in Ancient and Medieval India, Contributions to the History of Indian Mathematics, Sanskrit Prosody, Pingala Sutras and Binary Arithmetic, Pratyayas and Mathematikas and Fibonacci Numbers, or Brahmaputras and Kumar's Quadrilaterals, and Narayana Pandita's Enumeration of Combinations and Associated Representation of Numbers as sums of binomial coefficients, along with Dr. Sridharan and Dr. N.D. Srinivas. Interestingly, his review of two books appeared in the Max Student. One was Father Racine's Introduction to Abstract Algebra, and the other was N. Jacobson's Structure of Brain. Father Racine played a crucial role in introducing modern mathematics to talented Indian students in Chennai, which went a long way in putting India on the world mathematical map in the 1960s. Dr. Sridharan's passionate appreciation of Bodo's novels and Jeet has been immortalized in the newspaper column. About Srimati, she joined the bank in 1986 as the officer. She is well and highly qualified and worked in all categories of branches from rural to metro and super metros like Bombay. She was the head of one of the premium prime corporate branches at Mumbai with varied and rich experience coupled with progressive outlook and quick decision making. She scaled up to be a GM in 2016 and was heading Twin Wings at the head office, that is corporate credit wing and international operations, before joining Chennai Circle to steer, grow and enhance the image of the bank among all the category of customers and corporates. Presently, heading Chennai Circle, which is over. Presently, she is heading the Chennai Circle, which is spread over 17 districts, comprising of 499 branches, within a business of over 60,000 crores. The KSRI has been having accounts with the Canara Bank for over 30 years. Recently, we approached the leading banks in our locality to support our project financially. Madam, we are grateful to you for heeding our application and helping us so generously. We thank all the other members of the Canara Bank who are also instrumental in providing financial support to the institute. Thank you.
Over to Professor Sridharan for the next.
Yes, when this request came for financial support to the extent possible. Mainly, from a bank point of view, we have a very small budget allocated at our general manager level to undertake certain corporate social responsibilities. And maybe some publicity budgets. So on the budget pillar, we try to see what are the little bits, a wee bit that we can do to the society for the right cause. In the subject of bringing the ancient mathematics through Sanskrit and other living game, I felt this is one area where Canara Bank can be, we could not do the support that was actually expected because we have an annual budget and the annual budget we distribute along a very recently last week we went to the pledge of support to adopt a village, to adopt a village only instead. And various different type of activities is what we do try to support within our budget coverage. I'm extremely happy, feel grateful to having a very small help to this with the first book publication that's sponsored by Canara. I'm so happy to be a small part of it. Can I take this opportunity to hand over the my Mailapur Chief Manager Mr. Balasubramaniam and our Division Manager Mr. Sundaram is also here.
Apparently he was visited in Sanskrit College here and delivered prizes. And he said said, children, don't refuse this thing. Please go and see at least. For that reason, you should go. That's the reason. But I could say no, I could not say no. So I'm here. But yeah, honestly, I'm very happy to see people like Ramanand. See, I did not expect any, but I ended up with a by mistake. So that is the third thing I'm very happy to see. In fact, what was said of me about my stay in the class, that has to do with what you said about Ramanand. Very well for so many years, and I was very happy that he came, except I hope and hope that he is not disappointed when he goes in there. So, his wife is also here. So, the topic that I chose, I
know this is 67 years.
Sorry?
We have known each other for 67 years.
I am there.
You have known each other for 67
years.
You have known each other for 67 years.
67 years, yeah.
Yes. but it's, in fact, it was a mathematician. He, in fact, it was absolutely original mind. And his first work was called Ausgleichendes Lehre, his theory of displacements. And you know, it's a shame to think that this book, which he wanted published to his own efforts, and was kept in a library, in a shop, library, bookshop, absolutely no copies sold. So he was, in fact, about the thing they wanted to do it again, and they really literally burned the copies there. It was one of the dreadful things that could happen to a mathematician. But this is only just the beginning. And in fact, all through, he was never recorded at all. Regarded as a great mathematician at all. Until much later, the recognition came from his work on Sanskrit, his work on languages, his work on phonetics, his work on everything else. And in fact, I am going to list some of the things that he did. The greatest thing that he did was to translate the Rig Veda into German. Voluminous copies of two voluminous copies of German. I have a copy. And in fact, it's a remarkable piece of work. I attracted the attention of the people who are working there in Sanskrit. In fact, even all the professors, all the honorary scholars, who have made a member of the society, a free kind of society, and so on. But he never got a recognition for his mathematics. After he was dead, like so called experience, I think I asked him to and so on, in much later than all these. And even today, yes, Gassman is not very well understood because the very terminology was something very strange that he was not there. And to this day, and in fact, there are people who do to teach him also, where they believe in them, they go to you know, you make you this, that, and nothing happened. In fact, including Bush, in fact, he sent a paper to somebody. And they just ignored the paper. And in fact, they never wrote, you know, ignoring this paper of that. In fact, I want to go on and thank for all the things that I have. But one thing which touches my heart was that he had a great emotion for Sanskrit. And he worked in Sanskrit, whereas he could let this kind of great scholar. In fact, to him, I want to dedicate his great, you know, my great duty for that time. This is dedicated to. Now, I think it's perhaps not customary, but anyway, I would like to begin this picture. No? I mean, when I say something about contribution, blah, 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 let's forget this. Let me talk about the Sanskrit. So, let me quote for you. In fact, three arbitrary kind of scholars which are collected. To my reading, the answer is again, I'm in this strong emotion. One of the persons, one of the Sanskrit poets whose work really interests me is that of Vasa. See, Kalidasa is of course everybody talks about Kalidasa, every other person talks about Kalidasa and says how great a poet he was and so on. How many people really know about the work of Vasa? And Vasa was one of the greatest of Sanskrit poets. And in fact, we had in fact one of the greatest of Vasa. But that is not where I got. I really did not know much about Vasa at all. And too much later, as usual, my knowledge always came much later and I really did learn about this. But this thing I learned. But this day, I will start with one thing, three, two poems, and then one which was from Kalidasa, because he is a good student. So, and then I started. What I wanted to say, I don't want to take much of the time. So this is one. Siksha Chayam Gachet Kar Pajayat. Siksha, whatever you order, Chayam Gachet, it goes to waste. Kar Pajayat. As I went back, whatever you learn, you know. Subhadham Muna, Nipadanti, Vata Bahara Baha. See, very, very strongly, I mean, well, such trees also.